One of the world's smallest countries is building the world's largest port. Welcome to the Tuas Mega Port of Singapore. Stretching 16 miles with space for 66 berths, this mega project will eventually handle 65 million containers every single year, which is more than any other port on the planet. And it covers an area equal to 3,300 football fields. But how is a country smaller than New York City building a port this massive? And how is it all coming together step by step? Before we dock at Singapore's colossal port, make sure to drop anchor and subscribe to Design Zip for updates on the world's biggest engineering marvels. To understand the Tuas Mega Port, we have to rewind centuries. Singapore's entire story has always been tied to the sea. As far back as the 14th century, this small island was already acting as a key trading post in the Straits of Malacca. Chinese records described it as a place where rare goods like hornbill casks and lacquer wood passed through. Traders from South Johor and the Riau Islands relied on it as a gateway to bigger markets. That role as a connector never went away. By 1819, when Stamford Raffles turned Singapore into a free port for the British, the deep waters of Keppel Harbour instantly made it a magnet for regional trade. The trick was that there were no tariffs here and no restrictions, just ships in and out. Traders preferred Singapore over Batavia or Penang, and within a few decades, the island became a hub linking Chinese, Southeast Asian, and European routes. What's important is that Singapore never had the luxury of land or natural resources. No oil, no minerals, no big hinterland. Everything depended on imports and exports. Crude oil came in, refined fuel went out, electronics parts came in, high-value semiconductors went out. That dependence on ports is why, after independence in 1965, Singapore made its harbours its lifeline. And as global shipping scaled up, Singapore built container terminals in Keppel, Pasir Panjang, and Brani. But there was always a problem. They were spread out. Containers often had to be hauled across terminals by trucks, clogging up roads and wasting precious hours. With leases on older city terminals set to expire in 2027, Singapore needed a radical solution. That solution is Tuas. Let's look at the scale of this mega project. Phase 1 alone took 6 years to complete. To form its wharf, engineers used 222 gigantic caissons, which are massive watertight chambers weighing up to 15,000 tons each and standing 28 meters tall, about the height of a 10-story building. These are among the largest caissons in the world, chosen because they fit Singapore's shallow seabed better than traditional piling. Piece by piece, they have created a solid foundation stretching into the sea. By the 2040s, when all four phases are done, Tuas will have 26 kilometers of deep water berths, long enough to host the largest container ships afloat, and those ships are only getting bigger. Modern megaships can carry over 20,000 TEUs. That's 20-foot equivalent units, basically the standard measure for shipping containers, in one voyage, and Tuas is designed with that in mind. But it's not just the size that makes this port different, it's the machines running it. Tuas is already deploying more than 200 battery-powered automated guided vehicles, or AGVs, each capable of hauling two 20-foot containers or one 40-foot container weighing up to 65 tons. They move autonomously at up to 25 kilometers per hour, guided by underground transponders, RFID tags. That's radio frequency identification and a central fleet management system that ensures no collisions. Within a few years, that fleet will expand to more than 1,000 AGVs. On top of that, nearly 1,000 automated yard cranes will stack and shift containers with precision far beyond human capability. The entire system is monitored from a digital twin command center. Here, operators sit in front of massive screens and control and track the flow of containers without ever setting foot in the yard. This automation saves labor and also cuts emissions. These electric AGVs slash carbon output by half compared to diesel trucks. The port's smart grid integrates solar energy, and buildings are designed to use 60% less power than conventional ones. By 2050, Tuas is expected to run at net zero. But don't look at Tuas as just some engineering marvel. it is also a survival strategy for the country. Singapore knows that its economy stands or falls on its ability to stay the world's most efficient hub for global trade. Its prime location between the Indian Ocean and the Pacific places it along one of the busiest shipping lanes in the world. Every year, a fifth of global container traffic and about half of the world's crude oil flows through Singapore's waters. That alone explains why Tuas matters so much. Right now, Singapore's container traffic is spread across several older terminals, including Tanjung Pagar, Keppel, Brani, and Pasir Panjang. Each terminal was built at different times, and while they have kept the city-state at the top of global shipping rankings for decades, they come with a huge drawback. Containers often need to be hauled across the city by truck whenever they are transshipped between terminals. That means road congestion, higher costs, and slower turnaround times. For a country that sells itself on speed and efficiency, that's a major bottleneck. The leases for the oldest terminals expire in 2027, so Tuas comes just in time. By consolidating every container operation into one mega facility, Singapore removes inter-terminal trucking entirely. That alone makes shipping smoother, faster, and cheaper. To make it work, Singapore is building the capacity phase by phase to handle 65 million TEUs a year by the 2040s. Compare that to the 41 million handled in 2024 across all its ports combined. And there is a reason for aiming so high. Container ships are getting bigger every year, and not every port can handle them. Tuas's deep water berths and 16-mile length are designed for vessels so large that they make older docks obsolete. If Singapore didn't expand now, megaships might bypass it for ports in Malaysia, China, or even Sri Lanka. That's a risk Singapore cannot take. The economic impact is also massive here. The maritime sector already contributes around 7% to Singapore's GDP and employs about 170,000 people. With Tuas, this share is going to grow. Thousands of new jobs will come from high-tech roles, for example, fleet management, AI systems, marine engineering, and data analysis. The Maritime and Port Authority projects at least 5,000 new jobs by 2025, and many more as Tuas expands. Automation does replace some manual work, but it creates demand for a more skilled workforce. Tuas also strengthens Singapore's grip on global trade flows. The Strait of Singapore is one of the narrowest and most strategic choke points in the world. Ships cannot easily bypass it. The Straits of Johor to the north are blocked by the causeway with Malaysia. The Malacca Strait to the west funnels ships straight into Singapore's waters. Whoever controls these routes controls a significant part of global commerce. Tuas locks Singapore into that position for decades to come. So, when you ask why Tuas matters, it's because it secures Singapore's future. It solves current inefficiencies and reinforces the nation's dominance over one of the most important maritime choke points on Earth. But while Singapore is going all in, it's not operating in a vacuum. There are other ports around the world fighting for the same crown, and that's where the real competition begins. Let's start with Shanghai. For more than a decade, the port of Shanghai has been the king of container shipping. It handles around 50 million TEUs every year. It overtook Singapore in 2010, and since then, it has been setting the pace. But Tuas is being built with the goal in mind to take that crown back. At full capacity, Tuas will handle 65 million TEUs annually, nearly 30% more than Shanghai's busiest year. That's a huge jump, and it shows the boldness of Singapore's plan. Shanghai may have the size of China behind it, but Tuas is proof that scale doesn't always require land. It requires planning and ambition. Then there is Rotterdam. For centuries, Rotterdam was Europe's gateway to the world. Even today, it's Europe's busiest port, which handles around 15 million TEUs. It's a massive logistics hub with rail, road, and river links stretching deep into the continent. Yet compared to Tuas, Rotterdam looks small. 15 million versus 65 million is not even close. Now look at Dubai's Jebel Ali. It's the largest port in the Middle East, which handles about 13 to 15 million TEUs annually. Jebel Ali acts as the central hub between Asia, Europe, and Africa. with free zones that attract companies to base their operations there. But even Jebel Ali's highly integrated system doesn't come close to Tuas's projected numbers. And what about the United States? Los Angeles and Long Beach together form America's busiest container gateway. They process just under 20 million TEUs combined. That's enough to keep the entire West Coast economy moving, but again, Tuas alone will triple that figure. The gap is enormous, and it shows how much more Central Asia has become to global shipping compared to North America. Tuas also stands out in ways beyond numbers. Few ports are as fully automated as what Singapore is building. Rotterdam has automated terminals, yes, and Shanghai uses advanced technology. But Tuas is planned as the largest fully automated port in the world. The financial investment is also huge. The project will cost around $13.5 billion, spread over four phases and decades of construction. To put that into context, it's one of the most expensive infrastructure projects in the world right now. And unlike some mega projects that struggle with delays or overruns, Tuas is already operating, with 11 berths handling millions of containers since 2022. That shows Singapore's ability to actually deliver, not just promise. Singapore's Tuas Megaport is not just an engineering marvel. It's a bold strategy that secures the country's place at the center of global trade. From massive automated machines to record-breaking container capacity, this project shows how ambition, technology, and planning can reshape the future of shipping. In my opinion, Tuas is one of the most impressive infrastructure projects in the world today, and a perfect example of a small nation thinking on a global scale. What do you think? Could any other port compete with Tuas, or is this truly unmatched? Share your thoughts in the comments below. If you want to see more videos about groundbreaking architecture, mega projects, and world-class design, make sure to subscribe to DesignZip for the latest updates. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.